You know, zookeepers at the North Carolina Zoo watch the weight of all of their animals very closely because changing weight could be an early indicator of a health problem.
Some animals are pretty easy to weigh. Others, like alligators, are a little more challenging. Shannon Smith shows us in today's Zoo Files.
Come on,
these alligators have only eaten a few times since last fall.
So they're what people call cold-blooded. So they're not using a lot of energy and they're not spending a lot of energy. So they just kind of relax all winter long and they're not active and so they don't need to eat.
Late last year, Leave, the 20-year-old female, weighed in at 160 pounds. Gator Boy, the 42-year-old male, tipped the scale at 460. Now it's time to coax these two out of the water to check their current weights.
So those are the only times that we ask them to come out of the water with us, and we do not go in the water with them.
The keepers train the alligators regularly to respond to commands. But still, they realize there's a risk of being this close to these powerful creatures.
We always have two of us in there whenever the alligators are active. We have two gates, one on either end, so there's always an exit for us to get out so that we don't worry about getting trapped in with the alligators.
The keepers never force the alligators to move. Instead, they wait patiently, trying to entice them with food.
Wake up.
They need to get the alligators all the way up on this scale. That includes that very long tail.
Gator Boy is over 10 feet long, so we have to get all 10 and a half feet of him onto the ramp to get an accurate weight.
At first, the gators gave a great effort, making it almost all the way onto the scale. But then they got cold.
It was a little chilly this morning, and the water is heated, so they decided to return to the water instead of getting all the way onto the scale.
While today they didn't get their weight, the keepers say since the alligators responded positively, it's still a success.
We'll try it again in another couple weeks when it warms up, but they did a really good job.
At the North Carolina Zoo, Shannon Smith, Fox 8 News.
Now, four alligators live in the swamp section of the North Carolina Zoo. Remember, online ticket reservations are still required to visit.